Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at using iCloud Drive on the web to access your files from anywhere. So hopefully now that you've been using Yosemite for a while, you've been using iCloud Drive. This allows you to save your files in the cloud and have them available across all your Macs and in many cases on your iOS devices as well. And also everything's automatically backed up because it's not just saved on your hard drive, it's saved in the cloud as well. And you can access your iCloud Drive by going in the Finder to the iCloud Drive area, and you can see all the different folders here, including ones you've created on your own, like this one. I just created my own folder. These are for specific apps. So here's all my text edit documents saved on iCloud Drive. And I can also easily access that in TextEdit by just saving to iCloud, and that's where it automatically puts all the TextEdit documents. Now, to complete using iCloud, you need to learn how to use the iCloud Drive website. So while you can access all your files here on your Mac, if you want to access them from somewhere else, another Mac or even a PC, you can do that by going to iCloud.com. When you're at iCloud.com, you may have to sign in first, of course, if you're not signed in on that particular machine. But you have all of your different apps here. Like you can access your iCloud email, you can access the contacts and calendars, notes and reminders that have been synced from your Mac. And you can go into specific apps like Pages, Numbers, and Keynote to access the files in there. But you can also go to iCloud Drive here, and you get this kind of file system where you can access all of your files. And here are the different folders. These are the same folders I'm seeing here. You can even see there's my Project A folder. And I can look in any one of these. Let's look in Project A. I'm going to double click it there. And I can see my files in there. And you can navigate in here many different ways. You can use the back button. You can use the full path here to go back up to iCloud Drive level. And I can look, say, in my text edit folder here. And I can see there's all my text edit files, same as before. I can look in even other apps, like non-Apple apps, like Pixelmator uses iCloud, and I can see one document I've saved there. Now if I go into something like, say, Pages, Pages has an iCloud web app. So if I select it, if I double click it, it's not just I can download the file or maybe even upload new ones, as you notice here. I can actually work with the file here in the web app version of Pages. So it's going to open up and it's going to look kind of like I'm in Pages here. And I can fully edit this and work with it. And I've got almost all the controls I have in Pages on my Mac, except notice I'm in Safari. I'm not in Pages. And this would come up even if I was on another Mac that didn't have Pages, or even a PC that couldn't run Pages. I could still run the Pages web app, edit this document, and do all sorts of different things with it in iCloud.com. Now if there is no web app, like say for Pixelmator or for a PDF in Preview, then all you can really do is double click on it and it will download the copy. Which it could be useful, especially if there's a different type of app on the Mac or PC that you're using that can then access that file. You can then very easily upload to this directory by selecting the file and it will upload it. So you can get files in and out even if there isn't a web app. Now two things that may seem weird here are iMovie and QuickTime Player, because iMovie doesn't have the ability to, you know, save a project. It's kind of saved in a library. But if I go in there, I can see that there is actually something in there. And the way that got there was that in iMovie you're able to save a file, export a file from a video you're working on. So for instance, I can take this file I'm working on here, and this is one of the projects I've got, and I could share it via file, and I could see here that in the file sharing dialog I have the ability to go to a special iMovie iCloud folder. So it's not going to save the project, something you can edit in iMovie, but it will save the exported final product of your video as a file that then you can view in iCloud. So in Safari, if I were to double click this, it would actually load up that movie and show me in the web browser. It wouldn't require me to download it. And the same is true for QuickTime Player, for instance. I can access files. QuickTime Player, if I were to save a file out of QuickTime Player, I have the option to save it to the iCloud Drive QuickTime Player folder. So there are various different ways that different apps are used in the web version of iCloud Drive. Now you don't really have the full Finder-like control here in this web browser interface, but you do have the ability to do a few things. For instance, if I go into look at some files here, I can click once to select one, and I have this info button here. I can actually change the file name if I want right from here. I can get some information about it. Of course, I can select one or multiples holding the shift key there, the command key to add more, and delete them. I can download, I can upload new ones as I showed before. I can create new folders inside of here or inside of any of these, and I can even email them. So if I wanted to email this test PDF here, I could do it and it would open up the email interface on iCloud, but automatically attach that file to the email I'm about to send. The real advantage of using this and knowing about it is having access to your files anywhere. So if you go on a trip, for instance, and you've got all your documents saved on iCloud Drive, you don't have to worry about what if you need to access one of these documents. You can go use somebody else's computer, log into iCloud.com, and then quickly get access to any of the files you've got saved on your iCloud Drive.